Let's take a look at some of the options and preferences of audio montage. First, under File Group, I want to create an audio montage file. In this case, it will be a multi-channel free configuration of 8 channels, that's maximum, at 48K. Create. From there, I can go to File Browser and select a bunch of files, which I'm going to drag and drop within the file group. Now, if you can see that yellow bar here, it indicates where you want the files to be dropped. So in this case, I will drop them at about right here. I get this window, Insert Audio File, asking me which how I want those files to be laid out, staggered files or lined up. In this case, I choose place each file on separate tracks. Under View tab, I can zoom in and out horizontally using the mouse, or I could use the H and G key to zoom horizontally. And if I press and hold Shift, I can use the G and H key also to zoom vertically. You also have different options to move the cursor. For example, you can move the cursor to the next clip in here, the beginning and the end of the clip. You also have a ruler that you can insert. So you could select a clip and under ruler, activate the ruler. You could see here, so if I zoom vertically a little bit, you could see place the ruler on top of the selected track. You also can choose different colors for the track. And you can go up and down the tracks here with a little up and down arrow. Under Edit, you can edit a source, for example, this selected clip here, and it will automatically open an audio editor file, and you can edit the selected file here. Going back to Edit, you have different range options, start and options in here. You also can notch the cursor here. You can select a value, so minus 10 in this case. You can notch the cursor, or if you click on the lower portion of the clip, you can nudge the actual clip up and down based on the selected value here. Crossfade, snap to magnet, as well as waveform editor or spectrum editor. For example, you can select a region within that clip here. And by clicking on spectrum editor, it will automatically open that selected region within an audio editor here. Going back to edit. And finally, you can also select an external editor, for example, New Window 10 in this case, and it will open the selected clip in New Window 10. Under Insert, you can insert different type of markers, as well as audio files, video files, clip files, audio montage file directly from here. Under Process, you can set preferences for the loudness meter for the clip itself, the audio montage output, or the master section output, for example. You have different pitch shiftings, time stretch to cursor options, as well you can bounce different files or different sections, or create a superclip. Under fade, you can adjust the fade in, fade out with different variations available here. You can also highlight a section and say, let's put a fade out in here. You can actually click on the fade and change it manually if you want to. You can apply fade time as well, or you have different presets. Under envelope, you can range a section and zoom to envelope range. From there, you can just double click on the line in the middle here and change your envelope directly from here. You have different docking options for fall regions, rise regions, as well as dump factors here, as well as mute sections, raise sections. You can also convert. For example, convert to stereo, create independent envelopes for the left and right channel, for example. Analyze give you a different playback or monitoring options. Inputs, file rendering, can freeze meters as well. The render, you can again render the whole montage or selected audio range or selected CD track, etc. directly from here. You can rename all the files. Different options for bypassing the master section, for example, adding reverb tail, and you can start rendering.